Now we are going to discuss the development of anther from the male reproductive part, androecium. As already we have seen, androecium is made up of stamen. Stamen possesses anther and filament. Anther bears pollen grains, which represent the male gametophyte. So this anther, how it is developed? Means a very young anther develops as a homogeneous mass of cells surrounded by an epidermis. During its development, the anther assumes as four lobed structures, each lobe a row of few rows. Hypodermal cells becomes enlarged with a conspicuous nucleus. This functions as archisporium. The archisporial cells divide by periclinal divisions to form primary parietal cells. Periclinal division means it is a vertical division, so it develops parietal cells towards the epidermis and sporogenous cells towards the anther cavity. The primary parietal cells undergo series of periclinal divisions, that is, the cells which are produced externally. Primary parietal cells towards epidermis, it undergoes for series of mitotic division and forms 2 to 5 layers of anther walls. 2 to 5 layers of anther walls composed of endothecium, which is making endothecium, middle layers and tapetum from the periphery to the center.